Thank you. Good morning, everybody. First of all, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Vendula Hejlová and I am working at Forest Management Institute in the Czech Republic. And today I would like to present to you our National Forest Inventory and the results that are presented in the form of maps and graphs. So, here is a small introduction to my presentation. First of all, I would like to tell you something about National Forest Inventory in the Czech Republic. After all, I'm going to talk about map making tool and graph making tool. And finally, I would like to show you some results of the second cycle of National Forest Inventory. National Forest Inventory in the Czech Republic, it's an independent survey on the state and development of forest. And it's independent because it's not influenced by the owners of land that is forested. And we have three major aims. And the first one is to provide required information about forest for the need of the state administration. And the second one is to provide information from the evaluation of forestry activities. And the last one is to provide information about health condition of the forest. Our National Forest Inventory is divided into three cycles. The first one was carried out from 2001 to 2004. After all was quite a long pause. And after that, we had the second National Inventory cycle. And now we are at the end of the third National Forest Inventory cycle that is carried out from 2016 to 2020. So we evaluated the results from the second National Inventory cycle now, and we use modern technology for data collection, for data storage and data visualization. We use photogrammetric interpretation to detect forested areas. And at that forested areas, the field survey was carried out. For the evaluation, we used other auxiliary data in the form of GIS layers, such as digital elevation models or orthophotos, etc. So NFI results evaluation is based on survey sampling methods. We used one-phase estimations, and this approach was really good optimized. So let's say something about map-making tool. We used PostgreSQL to store our data in the form of views, and we used QGIS to visualize the data in the form of maps. So here are some important tables for map making and for preparation data for visualization. The most important tables are C-cartogram label table. You can see it at the bottom of the presentation. And there we store a form of labels that are displayed directly in the map. And the most important table is the cartogram configuration table. You can see it. You can see it. And I would like to say that we store there two important, or all the columns are important, but the column IDR C1 and IDR C2 are very important because of the source data for our map are stored there. Then we use identification of NFI cycle on NFI grid or geographical domain, and after that you can see there at the end of the table view name and description. Here is a set of functions that help us to make the concrete view for the desired cartogram. And the most important function is the red one. And this function creates a new view from data that were stored in the configuration table. And the result of this function are two views, one for the whole Czech Republic and one for the desired region or regions or geographical domain. Here is the result view map. Here is the result view, and this view is showing growth in the Czech Republic, and it's divided into 14 major regions in the Czech Republic. And you can see the red labeled columns that shows the data from the source views. And we have there point column that shows the point estimation of the growth in the area. And we can see a confidence interval for this point. And we have there four red depicted columns. It's because two of them are in the whole numbers and two of them are in a ratio, so that we can display it in a map and in the form of a cartogram. Here you can see the result that shows the mean annual growth in the Czech regions between the first and the second national inventory cycle. So we automatized everything that was possible in QGIS, and we have this map. You can see that the highest growth in the Czech Republic is in the eastern and in the southern part of it. So let's move to the graph making tool. We developed it we use it in a virtual environment, and graphs are made in PostgreSQL, and we are using PLR extension. Every graph has its own PLR functions, and these functions are stored in our database. The result of the process are two images, one in the PNG format and one in SVG format. Here you can see the tables for graph making. The first one is C function for plot. It's a dial, and you can see there the list of function names and description. And the most important table is also a configuration table, and you can see at the bottom of this slide. And there are stored data about source views, about geographical domain. There is stored a name of the resulting plot, and we store the resulting plots in the database right now in the form of PNG or SVG. It can be both or one of them, and then we download them from this database. So here is a set of functions that help us to create the images. The most important function is fngetplot function that creates one or two images from the information included in the configuration table. And as I said, we use a PLR function for every single graph. Here you can see the PLR function for the growth in the Czech Republic. It's for the whole Czech Republic, and you can see that first of all, we select data, and we select data in a form of rows. We are not using ODBC connections to the database, but we decided to select data in the rows from the view. And after that, we declare image size, image resolution, and margins. And the rest of the code is about graph properties. There are defined X and Y axis labels, colors, and so on. And here is the resulting graph. And this graph shows growth, as you can see, on epsilon axis, and the X axis shows age categories, and the growth is divided into these age categories, so that you can see and this graph is for the whole Czech Republic. And you can see that the highest amount of growth is in the age category 21 to 30 years, and after that, it's slightly decreasing. So our NFI results are divided into chapters according to the major theme. And these major themes include, for example, forest area, age structure, growth, mortality, dead trees, forest regeneration, and damages caused by game, NTC. And we are aimed not only for forest factors, but we study the environment and geographical environment, and we included chapters such as pedology, water streams, erosion in deforested areas. So, and I would like to show you results from the chapter forest area and water streams right now. Here, this graph shows the amount of forest area in the Czech Republic according to FAO declaration, so that you can see that forest covers 36.8% of the area of the Czech Republic, and not forested areas covers 61.3% of the land. Here you can see some maps, and these maps shows forest area in regions, and this forested areas is in the elevation below 400 meters above sea level. And these maps, I gave here these maps to show you the name of the major regions, and you can see that the highest amount of forested areas below 400 meters is in the capital city of Prague and in the southern Moravian. And here is the same graph, but with labels that we are using. And the first row shows the whole amount of forest area in these regions below 400 meters, and the second row number shows the percentage, and the percentage is showed in this map. Here is the same example, but here you can see forested areas in the elevation from 400 to 700 meters in the Czech Republic, so that the highest amount of forested in this elevation is situated in the center of the Czech Republic, where Czech Moravian highland is situated. And here is the last map showing this problem, and here are showed forested area in the elevation above 700 meters above sea level, so that you can see that the highest amount of forests in this elevation is situated in the South Bohemia, where Šumava mountains are situated. So, and here is the same information in a graph. As you can see, Y axis shows the names of regions, and X axis shows the representation of elevation categories on the forested land. So you can decide which visual representation you can use or brings more information for your project, and you can use it. And here's something about water streams in the Czech regions, in Czech Republic. Here this map shows water streams that are natural and that are situated in the forested areas. You can see that the highest amount of natural water streams is situated in the eastern part of the Republic. And it's because there are a lot of forest, and in the other regions, artificial water streams are is more artificial water streams. So here is it's not working. So So here you can see a graph, and this graph shows the division of water streams to natural and artificial origins, and it's also divided into the wideness of a channel. You can see that artificially created water streams are not so wide as the natural ones, and the wideness that dominate is under 1 meter only. So, and that would be everything for me, and I would like to thank you for your attention. And if you have any questions, do not hesitate to ask me.
So, any questions?
There's one, thank you. You want the microphone, or you can just speak up?
Yeah, just speak up.
Okay, so, natural forest inventories, they are all over the countries in Europe. How open is the policy in your country in terms of getting the raw data or something like modified data in terms of a cell level or something like that? Do you share them in terms of using for research purposes at least?
I think that I'm not able to answer correctly this question because it's not my field. But I think that we are not so open to provide data. And I think that it's a pity, but in the Czech Republic, it's a problem to provide data, I think. Only for students, it's for free, and then it's not so easy to get them.
I think I agree with you that it's really funny that governments spend a lot of money pulling out data, and then if you're lucky, at least in Italy, you get maybe a PDF, which is then you have to take all the tables out of the PDF, and I go crazy because I say if you make the tables from, you probably have Excel, why don't at least you give us some type of spreadsheet? And that's always very hard to get through, but I think slowly we'll be getting there. But my question was, since we have a bit of time, is how big are your tables? Because you do a lot of views and maybe joins. And did you find that it might slow up the system, or are your data not so numerous? So you can just, because there's materialized views now in Postgres, maybe you might want to use.
I think that the tables are not so big. But we have a lot of them. These tables store only the data. And I don't know how to say it, but the storage is not a problem. The problem is the computation of the data. It takes a lot of time because of a lot of factors goes to the computation, and it's quite a problem right now, but the storage of the data is not. The tables are quite small because of there are only numbers for, I think, I don't know. We do not count everything for the smallest regions like catastrophes areas. And I think that's not a problem right now. Maybe it will be a problem in the future.
So any other questions for the speaker? No? Okay. Well, then we'll just wait for the next one at 9:30. And we thank the speaker again. Thank you.